Hello, everybody. Welcome to Prayer and Fasting Service. This is our 27th day, and we're going to the 30th, as far as I know. The Lord says go further, we will. We do this every day anyway, but usually not opened up to the public. But in the month of September, it's different every year, but the Lord said just do it this way this year, so that's what we did. And still doing it. Amen. So we're getting ready to jump into the Word. If you have your Bible or a tablet, or you can follow along with us and take notes, or go back and write this out, or listen to it, or however you want to do it. Take a mental note. This is a devotional that God has given me years ago, and we just continuing in it. Faith always continues. Why do we pray the way we pray? 1 Timothy chapter 2, verse 1 through 2. First of all, we pray for all the people in authority that we live a quiet and peaceable life. Matthew 6, 33. Seek ye first the kingdom of God, and all these things are added unto us. Psalms 118, verse 17. Everybody in my family and the people in authority, they live and not die and declare the works of the Lord. President Trump and his cabinet and his family. Psalms 118, verse 25. We are now prosperous, healed, set free, delivered. And we are free from worldly passions, delivered from worldly passions. And the Trump family is Psalms 91. We walk in divine health, wealth, and prosperity. We are the healed, saved, set free, and delivered. And we walk in divine protection. Romans 8:11, the people in authority, the Trump administration, and President Trump is quickened in a mortal body. 2 Timothy 1:7, God hadn't given Trump or his administration the spirit of fear, the power of love, and a sound mind. Ephesians, the first chapter, verse 16 and 17, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ gives unto us the spirit of wisdom and revelation knowledge of Jesus, that the eyes of our understanding are enlightened, and we know what the hope of our calling is, an exceedingly great power that works on the inside of us. Isaiah 54:17, no weapon formed against the Trump administration will prosper. Every tongue that rises up against will not prosper, and no weapon formed against him will prosper. And every tongue that rises up is condemned. 1 Peter 2:24, by his stripes were healed. Isaiah 53:5, by his stripes were healed. And every tongue rises up is condemned. 1 Peter 2:24, by his stripes were healed. Isaiah 53:5, by his stripes were healed. Psalms 51:12, the joy of our salvation. Thank you, Lord. We are restored to the joy of our salvation. We have a free spirit. John 14:26, but the Comforter, which is the Holy Spirit, will come and teach us and lead us and guide us and direct us in every area of life. Matthew 8:17, John 14:26, we having Ephesians 3:20 life, more than you could think, dream, or imagine. Matthew 8:17, sin, sickness, and disease is a thing of the past. It's gone, gone, gone. Now, now, now. It's been removed from us. Sin, sickness, and disease is removed from us. Luke 10:2, we send laborers through the Trump administration. Godly people, we don't wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities and powers and rulers of darkness, and we bind and gag them in Jesus' name. Luke 10:2, release laborers to the Trump family, friends, neighbors, acquaintances, people that love us, people that hate us, people that bless us, people that even try to curse us, but every seat's filled. Every person is filled at Unity of Faith Church, a real church for real people, with real answers that have a real faith. We have now Deuteronomy 8:18, the power of wealth. I have trillions and trillions and trillions of dollars to get the gospel out in a greater way. 1 Peter 4:7, man, the world's coming soon. So we are disciplining our prayer life.
Glory.
Glory. In Isaiah 55:5, God has sent to us nation and nations, and they obey. You have a good evening. We will see you mañana on Thursday on the 28th. Have a great one. Have a good one. God bless.